Alright guys, so in this video I just wanted to talk about my Veritas Portlander here, which this guitar is amazing, super versatile guitar. The fit and finish on this is probably the best that I've ever seen on a guitar. And it's been my main guitar for the last 5 to 6 years, but recently I've been having lots of tuning stability issues. Mostly to do with the Bigsby, and whenever I would use it, I could tune up and I would basically touch the Bigsby and all six of my strings would go a good bit flat. And then if I tuned them after they had gone flat and used the Bigsby again, they'd all be sharp. And it's like no matter what I was doing, I could not get the guitar to stay in tune after using the Bigsby. So typically when when you're having tuning issues on a guitar, it's either your nut, your tuners, your bridge, or if you have a trim system like a Bigsby or a tremolo bar, it could also be something there. On this guitar, I'm almost certain the tuners and the nut are okay, so I'm feeling like the issue on my guitar is the possibly in the bridge or the Bigsby. So I just want to share with you guys some things that I'm doing to help improve the tuning stability of my guitar. So one thing is I wanted to mention is with these roller bridges, I believe this is a Tone Pros bridge. And so the way this is constructed is it has all these individual saddles, and then there's actually a little roller bar with show you real quick, but you can actually take these little guys out. So let me pop one out for you, and you can see right there that it actually comes off. And then this guy, this little piece, is just like a tiny little rod with a roller on it. So here's another, just look at it. So you got this tiny roller piece and then a little roller bar, and that actually goes on here. And each one of these, I found that all of mine had gotten pretty gunky and grimy, just because that's an area that collects a lot of dust and dirt, and then as well if you sweat at all, it can kind of just get a lot of buildup. And so I cleaned it, took it apart. I had like a little just spare toothbrush that I used and kind of cleaned up in there, wiped everything out. And right off the bat, I can notice that there's a lot less friction on these rollers, and they tend to kind of spin longer and seem to be maybe that's going to help, because it's cleaner and there's not as much like gunk in here. Because before, I think these things barely rolled, like there's just a lot of dirt and grime on it. So anyway, that's one thing that I've done with the bridge that I think is going to help. Another thing I wanted to talk about is the actual Bigsby. And so there's this one guy that I've watched a couple of his videos. I think it's Dylan Talks Tone. He's had some great wisdom and insight on Bigsbys and what can cause them to have tuning instability. One being, I'm going to take this thing apart. And I have like a penny in here, some other stuff. I can talk about that in a second. But one being is sometimes people, when you tighten a Bigsby, you see you got four screws. You got these two here, you got a screw there, and a screw up here. If they are tightened in an uneven way, you'll get binding on this bar. Like you want this thing that when it's on your guitar and you got your strings off, this thing should be able to flow and just move very smoothly while attached to the guitar. Sometimes when people tighten them down on the guitar, they think you got to crank it all the way down so that it's like flush and like snug up against the body. And that's actually not how these are designed, because they have little felt pads. And it's actually supposed to just rest gently on those felt pads. So that's one thing to check. And I had already checked that previously, and that was not causing issues on my guitar. So that wasn't, like, I know that I wasn't creating tension or having this bar bind up. So the next thing that came to mind is to possibly look at this front roller, which one of the reasons I want to make this video is I am going to be upgrading to the Callahan front roller, which I have here, this little guy. This is like a solid core. It's like cold pressed steel, and a lot of people say that this is a great upgrade for Bigsby's. They say you have improved tone or improved sustain, and I'm hoping that it's going to help me with some of my tuning. I'm going to just take this apart right here and show you one thing. Okay, so in taking this front roller out here, I'm going to just set this aside. You'll notice that the way the original one that comes on the Bigsby is you have your pin and then you have kind of two bearings and then like a hollow tube. And so one thing that I've never liked about this roller is that I feel like because you have like, right here, I feel like you have a little bit of wiggle room between the bearing and the bar. And then when you put the bearing in the actual cylinder piece, there's even more wiggle room. And so even with this thing kind of put together, I've always felt like there was a decent amount of wiggle room in here. And even if I put this back on the Bigsby itself, you can, obviously there's a little wiggle room side to side, but there's kind of a good amount of wiggle room front to back, like this way and that way. And when I've always when I've had my guitar strung up and I've, you know, had it where I was playing it, there's so much tension pushing up on this thing. And with that amount of wiggle room, I always felt like that was like a binding point and there was some friction there because it almost would shift it up and there would create a gap. And so it wasn't like an easy frictionless flowing circle. With the Callahan upgrade, which is this, there is a lot less wiggle room, like barely any. So if I put this on the Bigsby, even this rod that goes through the Bigsby, I can feel is tighter. And then here, like when I try to wiggle it, it's not really wiggling hardly much. I mean, there's just, you know, it's like probably the perfect tolerance so that the bar goes through and it's not binding on the bar, but there's not as much wiggle room at all. So that's another thing that I'm gonna be doing. Hopefully that helps. Another thing I wanted to talk about was with Bigsby's is another mod I just did was I took a, because a lot of times when you have this Bigsby sitting like this on the guitar, this bar or the tremolo arm, it'll be sitting flush and it can be almost so low that it's like harder to grab and pull up. And a lot of people, to make the tremolo arm go higher, they'll just put, like, you know, you can put a penny inside here. You know, some people use plastic washers. I've just used a penny. You can put more and more pennies and washers and you'll make this thing kind of stand up higher. The only thing with doing that though is that actually I think throws the Bigsby out of balance, because when you have the right amount of tension on it, you want it to somewhat still be resting kind of flat. And so kind of a compromise that I came up with to get a little bit more height with my tremolo arm is I just put, like, it was from my kids. They had like a button collection and, you know, they just play with it and stuff. And so I took one of the buttons, drilled a hole, like a clothing button, drilled a hole through the middle of it and basically made a washer out of it so that it's a little bit higher. Another reason I did that is because, originally from the factory, the Bigsby had a thin paper washer, and eventually that paper washer just disintegrated and was shredded. And so I didn't want there to be metal on metal just grinding. I feel like that would create even more friction. So that's another reason why I went with this plastic just clothing button. Okay, so that's all that I'm going to be doing with this Veritas to get it strung up, and I'll get some strings back on this thing and test it out, and hopefully we have less tuning problems and it just stays in tune more. And if there's anything else that I discover along the way, I'll be sure to maybe post another video. And if you guys have any thoughts or comments on things that you've done to fix tuning stability issues with your Bigsby's, post it in the comments because I'd love to know. It would probably greatly help me out and I would really appreciate it. Thanks, guys.